We saw examples of inference attacks. The two quick examples when the query was an average of an exam grade that was authorized, but the result was disclosing, you know, somebody's grade, which we didn't want that to happen. So obviously, we want to have defenses against these kind of inference attacks. These defenses actually are pretty hard. In general, if you can submit an arbitrary number of such queries, you can always make an inference based on the results those queries return. But there are some things that we can do to reduce the likelihood of somebody finding sensitive information by using such queries with at least limited amount of effort. What kind of defenses can we have in place? So remember, the way we do these aggregate queries that are allowed is that the query sort of says, select a set of tuples. So for example, that case we had where we're looking for junior standing, we're going to pull out all the tuples where the standing attribute value is junior. So we're going to pull out all the tuples that match this query in some sense, and then we're going to aggregate the exam score. So one way to make sure that inference is more difficult is that we don't do that when the number of tuples that are selected is too few. The idea here is when it's too few, extreme case when it's one, then we know that the average actually discloses the score that we have. But if it's a small number of tuples, the average is going to be close to the score of every person who is selected or whose tuples are selected. So average for a small set essentially tells us what those values are, and we don't want to do this average query when the number is too small. Well, you can think of other cases where if you're asking for some property and that selected set of tuples is very large, then that sort of holds for everyone. And if it holds for everyone, then it holds for a given user as well. So both too small and too large actually lead to this inference problem. I'll let you think about the too large part. But so you should see the aggregation is happening over a set of tuples. And does it include every tuple or almost every tuple in the database? Or does it include very few? And depending on the nature of the query that we have, you may say that, you know, we can't run that query because of the number of these tuples that it's going to aggregate over. So that's one way to do that. The other defense that we typically do is saying, well, we can transform the data, the database, and can remove all the identifying information. Think about the exam score that I was talking about. Let's say we drop the student ID and standing, even if you're concerned about too few students with a certain standing, and then we're just posting the exam score without the names or the IDs.